celebrity. Doesn't matter how big you are, how high your profile is, there always is a danger. But Jade, she was getting burnt alive. But you know what? She was a duck and diver and she knew how to work it. Come and look at the game she played. She never let that game start. No, not once. Right the way until she died. Jade used to say, Mum, listen, it's Wonga. Good or bad news, now it's work. And you know what? Why not?
This is a summary of findings by Ofcom, the communications regulator, about the Channel 4 series Celebrity Big Brother. Ofcom has concluded that Channel 4 failed to handle appropriately the strong content it was transmitting.
Hello, good afternoon. The Celebrity Big Brother contestant Jade Goody has denied she's racist after being voted off the reality television show by viewers.
Biggest professional gaffe since Gerald Ratner called his own brand of jewellery. Well, you know what he called it. She has a multi-million pound business empire, which instead of having shareholders, has fans.
Jade Goody is an absolute disgrace to Britain. How is she going to repair the damage she has caused to herself?
I am so sorry. I am.
Jade had left the Big Brother house, gone into hiding. She called me, and she was devastated. You know, she couldn't see a way back. Pretty much everyone had left her. There was no TV show. It was not good to be associated with a racist, and that's what people called her.
What happens to you now?
Well, I've not thought about my career. I've not thought about
nothing. Do you think you have a career?
No, quite frankly, no.
When she came out, Celebrity Big Brother, I always said to her, look, we're going down here, but we're going to come back up again. I tried to explain it to her like a Disney film. And she was always like, what do you mean Disney film? And I was like, look, you've got your happy, nice, glowy days, Cinderella's getting married. And she looked at me and I went, and then the bad witch comes along or there's a storm or a bad moment happens. She goes, yeah, and then what? And I went, and then it'll go good again. And then it'll go bad again. And it'll go good again. And then she started to understand that's the way the press were treating her.
She was like, right, I need to sort this out. This has happened now. How do we move forward? I want meetings, what's going to happen? How am I going to get back on top? How are we going to get back on TV? She was always going to get back on TV in some way, shape or form. It was just how she was going to do it, I think.
Hello, I'm Max Clifford, public relations consultant. I guess you can say I'm famous for making other people into celebrities.
To me, Max Clifford was about himself. About what he can get out of it.
That's great. Okay, thank you very much.
Yeah. I mean, Max was somebody that preferred the camera being on him than his clients. Yeah? And so, in some regards, I felt that Jade was being used. But we were coming to the end of the line with Jade, and I was yesterday.
We called him MC. He had the clients, he had the Rolls Royce. The office in Mayfair. He was the biggest PR that there was. I remember Jade saying to me, he represents OJ Simpson. He looks after Simon Cowell. And for this young Jade from South East London to be accepted and be on the books of Max Clifford, this was it for her. Max at that time was so powerful. He controlled the tabloid headlines. He could soften the tone in the way certain newspapers were writing about her. That at the time was critical for Jade. A spark in her eye was coming back.
I was a celebrity personal trainer and we just started training together. She was gonna get fit and she was gonna start eating healthy. Things seemed to fall into place. She was going to events, she was doing photo shoots, she was in the zone. And it was just like, pow!
Hold it there, Jade.
Jade, look into your eye, darling.
Jade, look up.
Everything was perfect. Everything went so well. And then I got this phone call. So, Mum, what's happening? I need to talk to you. Max Clifford wants me to go to Big Brother. I said, no, no, not happening. She said, no, listen to me. India.
Big Boss is back.
Somebody's watching you. Somebody's watching you.
Remember, Mum, they burnt me alive everywhere, and I need to show them that I'm not racist.
Big Boss is back.
Somebody's watching you. Somebody's watching you.
Oh, come on. That shelf machete. That's a good idea, is it? Going into India, brother? You're going to be India on your own. Yeah, Mum. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And what happened between me and Shilpa Shetty is in the past, and I'm not proud of it.
Jade was up for it, big time.
The people of India only see a small, small amount of me, and I want people to see there's more to me than what they see, as you know.
I really have to salute your spirit, Jade. You really have a never-say-die attitude, and I'd like to wish you all the very best.
Thank you.
Very
good. Jade looked really calm and she's happy going inside the Big Boss house.
Pehla din, subah paane 9 baje.
Dosto, Jade Goody Hindi nahi janti. Aur Big Boss ke ghar mein.
Me and my team, we have conversations with the Indian production team about how they should do the show. And everything went smoothly. So we left the set and went to the airport. And then after some security checks, I found out I had a lot of missed calls. So I was like, what's happening?
Let me show you. You're nice.
Doctor had called and they have to talk with Jade.
Jade, aap confession room mein aa jaye. बिग बॉस के घर में फोन की अनुमति नहीं है लेकिन अगर मामला संवेदनशील हो तो बिग बॉस बात करने की अनुमति दे देते हैं बिग बॉस ने जेट की बात लंदन स्थित उनके डॉक्टर से कराई
Someone's not lying to me. I'm playing a joke.
वो जेड गुड़ी अंदर गई है ना? कब से गई है?
इधर हो गया.
गुड़ी.
गुड़ी.
Can't tell you anything. I just got a call from a doctor in London.
This is about you, your health.
Okay, okay, no problem, no problem. We're here.
क्या है?
उसको बताने की जरूरत नहीं है सर्वाइकल कैंसर
इट वॉज हॉरिफिक I can't believe they did that. I can't believe she was told like that. Any camera people or producers, if in doubt, keep filming, isn't it? You know. But morally, they should have stopped it. That was for reality TV, a step too far.
I mean, it's just breathtaking what happened to her. So she goes over to India as a sort of olive branch, also to make herself some more money. And then Max calls her in the middle of the series and says, you've got cancer. I mean, surely the most shocking thing ever to happen on reality television.
It was about 1:30 in the morning, and I got a phone call. She was sobbing. She went, "Mom, I'm so scared, I'm on my own. No one can understand me, and I'm dying. What do I do? I'm dying." I couldn't deal with it. I didn't say nothing, nothing at all. And all I got was, "What kind of mother are you?" And put the phone down on me.
I was very mad. I was incredibly mad because I told the production, no cameras, no sound, nothing like that. But they film everything. This is not right. Someone had to take her out of the house and bring her back to the UK. And I was totally not convinced that they were going to do that. It felt like the station wanted to keep her in, see what happens with the ratings because it's great ratings, and that's bullshit. So I said, well, what's going to happen is I'm going to get her out of the house.
Oh.
We went to the airport and Sky News was on. UK woke up, news broke out. It's insane.
The Sun this morning, agony for reality star Jade Goody. She has been diagnosed with cervical
cancer.
Reality
TV star Jade Goody has cut short her appearance on the Indian version of Big Brother after being told on air that she has cervical cancer.
She's been diagnosed with the early stages of the disease.
It depends how deep the cancer has got into Jade's body, and that's unclear at the moment. As with any cancer, it can be fatal.
She was called into the diary room to be given the news by her doctor. We'll hear from our health reporter in just...
Was it more a case of exploitation than entertainment?
The whole world knew, but I didn't have any idea because I didn't know that that conversation was being filmed. That's not right. When I got off the plane, I felt naked. I just felt like everyone was looking at me. It was so personal and close to me, and I felt very lonely, actually. I just wanted to be cuddled.
I was filming in Afghanistan, and my exec called me to say, you have to call Jade. And I'll never forget it because there was a chopper taking off near me and I was trying to shout down the phone to hear her. And I was like, what's wrong? They've told me to call you. And she said, I've got cancer. I was like, what? I've got cancer. They've told me I've got cancer. So I just wanted to ask you, what do we do about it?
Okay, spin.
And I said, well, we do what we always do.
Okay,
tell me about when you first found out you're ill. Where were you? What did they say to you?
Ain't
that stupid? I'm just going to ask you. Ain't that stupid? No, because the whole entire world knows.
No, it's not stupid. It's not.
You've got to remember, Jade filmed for most of her life. So to her, even when she had cancer, the cameras being there, the people being there all the time, it was normal.
This morning.
I spent years with her, like hours and hours, days and days. You know, we had been there with her family all the time. We had become part of her family. For her to not film after so many years of doing it would have been weird.
I'm on air in 10 minutes. I'm rushing around to this morning.
What are you going on this morning to do?
To talk about this.
5, 4, 3.
On today's show, in her first live television interview since being diagnosed with cervical cancer less than 3 months ago, Jade Goody reveals why she's determined to beat it for the sake of her children.
You've got this really quite intensive period of treatment coming up, starting on the 15th.
Yeah.
And the panto starts on the...
Two days after.
Yeah. Is that wise? What do your medical team say? That,
well,
you should be going back to work?
I've got a great medical team, and if I give up, if I stop, I know my brain will eat over and I will just get depressed and I will be dead. And I don't want to be that. I want to just carry on being, to the boys and to myself, normal, because me staying busy is my way of me getting better.
she's been criticised, as we know, in the past for, you know, living her life as a reality show and selling everything. But at the moment, she says,
that's
I don't
what
care
she is.
What
she said, think. I've loved being a reality TV star. I'm doing what comes naturally to me.
Do you ever worry that sometimes you're on this big old treadmill and you're going, juggling all those balls in the air and maybe it doesn't quite sink in?
Like, no, it doesn't. I'm quite naive with the whole character thing and I haven't done any research or anything. I don't want to know.
Well, Jade and all your family, we really are thinking of you.
Even when she had cancer, she was so brave. She kept going and kept going and kept going. At the start, I found it easy. We were bringing awareness to a sensitive issue. We were back like the old times filming again. But there was a couple of days where we couldn't get hold of Jade. And that's when it got difficult. We ended up doorstepping her. We turned up at her house. She was not good. She was in a mess.
Listen, shall I have a hear that?
No.
You feel better?
Oh, no. Fine. I just don't want to go. I just don't want to go. I don't want to do this anymore.
You
don't know how I feel.
I never felt in an awful situation. I never felt like I was filming something I shouldn't. I always felt like Jade had the right to turn around and say no. Would I do it differently now than I did then? I don't think so. Because she wanted it. She wanted us there, and I think she'd have found going through chemotherapy and all of that really hard without us.
Jay, can you just tap your chest again? Just show us a bit on your chest. Is it like that, yeah?
Mm.
And just pick up the plastic bit. Just hold the tube. Great, cheers.
Can we just do one shot for 20 seconds of Jade on that bed with that purple scarf on? Just completely separate, as this is a line of voiceover.
Jade has chemotherapy.
There's no nice way to put this, really. The cancer kind of elevated her value as a news story. It was just a perfect news of the world fodder. Another dramatic twist. You know, fucking hell, look at that. And then it was like, okay, right, we need to get the first picture of her, you know, with no hair. This was a major priority. And Max Clifford brokered that deal. Oh, wow, it made papers fly off the shelves.
Front page of the New World, Movable Dead. Never thought I'd see that as a front pager or any pager.
There's paparazzi.
We're hiding.
I don't think Jade ever had any choice but to embrace what was happening to her. Right from the beginning, she was being sort of moulded into this tabloid creature.
Nice and tight. Good stuff.
See you later. Bye, boys. See you later.
I mean, she may have thought she had a choice in these matters, but actually, you know, it was a Faustian pact.
Hello.
Part of Max Clifford's stick was to look like he wasn't professionally representing his clients, but he was in Jade's sense, almost a father figure. He was trying to protect her and nourish her.
Obviously, the most important thing is your health and well-being.
and that's how it's got to be and will continue to be. You've all talked
about. But I met Max Clifford around the time of Big Brother, and he was like a vampire, and there was nothing there, really. Very, very much in a really crappy suit, pretending that he was on the side of good. But he wasn't really helping her. He was seeing her as the brand. And to some extent, Max Clifford dragged Jade Goody into the shit of the celebrity tabloid world.
The truth was, Jade didn't know what privacy was. I don't think she would even know what to do with it, to be honest. If I was to ask myself, like, who was exploiting who, I would say that she took responsibility for the fact that she had almost created that hype. She had benefited from that hype. And so therefore, I don't think she spent a great deal of time wishing that it wasn't there at times when she probably could have done with a breather.
There might be a point in this programme where I say, it all gets too much for me and I don't want you around anymore. But at the minute, I'm all right. This is just another part of Goody's life that is being filmed. Most of it has been. Why not the toughest part of my life be?
Good morning. Less than 2 weeks ago, Jade Goody was delivered the devastating news that her cervical cancer had spread to her liver, the bowel and groin. Just last Friday, doctors confirmed the worst. Jade's cancer is terminal and she has just months to live.
Jade's doctors have not given her a survival rating. They've just said that they're now treating her to prolong her life so she can spend as much time as possible with her children.
She will not be shying away from the limelight, Goody. Has said she's determined to earn as much money as possible to leave to her two sons.
Well, speaking exclusively to us this morning, one man who's been by Jade's side throughout all of that treatment, a close friend and publicist, Max Clifford.
Max, send her our love, I know.
She's watching you now, so you can do that.
Jade, good morning, love.
It was a case of, like, there's nothing more we can do for you. We'll give you chemo and we'll give you all this treatment, but we haven't got it. That's when we said, what are we looking at here? We're looking at a year. They was like, no. We're looking at months. They was like, no.
In her mind, she always dreamt, she dreamt of her wedding. You know, she's crying, saying, I dreamt of getting married when you can get married. She went, Kevra, there's no time. And I'm like, there is, you can do anything, Jade. We'll make it happen.
We'll get some rest.
I wanted to give her some hope that it's not all, that something might happen.
I don't know. I just wanted to marry her.
We went for a walk down the river and then I just remember getting down on one knee. She was so happy, she was so buzzing.
Naturally, we captured her engagement. It was a Sunday morning and Jack said to us, come down to the footpath of the River Thames. I remember she gave me that wink. She knew what she was doing still. I think we're exploiting each other. So, look, she got what she wanted from us and we got what we wanted from her. And it worked for two, it worked both ways amazingly.
Jade Goody is set to marry her fiance Jack Tweed in one of the most high profile celebrity weddings of the year.
Friends say planning her big day has come as a welcome relief from her painful battle with cancer.
It was the fact of, I'm getting married and this is the date. And we're like, what do you mean that's the date? She's like, yeah, we've got like, what,
11 days. We had to literally do her wedding for her, organise it.
She gave us all jobs to do.
Hey, get off. You're a bridesmaid, get off.
What?
The camera. You're a bride. You're late for picking things. You're not doing nothing. You know, it's a bit silly, isn't it?
2, 4, 6, 8. That's 10. We can fit one more person.
That's Richard and Judy. Where am I going to put them?
I don't think our skills set for like a week. Up London to the florist and the cake tasting, then we had to get our bridesmaids' dresses. And then our greatest day, and it's a day I'll never forget, is picking her wedding dress.
Hi!
Hiya! I remember we got a cab to Harrods.
So we're in a taxi, I'm in a wheelchair, Caroline's on the floor.
They shut the whole wedding department for Jade. We were like, wow, you know, it's amazing.
I'm being measured, the girls are eating, drink the champagne, all these beautiful dresses.
Thank you. It's beautiful. Get it off and get some more. Let's go.
She said, is there any chance I can get this for free? And I'm pretty sure she even said, because I'm dying. And we were like, you can't, surely you can't say that.
Jade's gone. Well, it's pointless me paying for these shoes. I'm only going to wear them once, and then I'm going to go, ain't I? So they was like, OK, you can have your shoes free as well.
Jade's made several appearances at her home here in Upshire in Essex today and seems to be on extremely good form. She walked the car rather than using her wheelchair and paused the car outside the gates here so that photographers could get plenty of shots of her.
Her drip snagging as she got out of the car, a permanent fixture now to give her pain relief. The couple emerged later hand in hand for a photo call. Jade Goody's dramatic weight loss clearly evident.
Jade Goody is set to marry her fiancé Jack Tweed on Sunday, and the event is likely to be a lavish affair.
This is more than just a celebrity wedding. It was a massive, massive showbiz event.
Thanks very much.
Jade Goody was kind of like an icon to our readers. Her story was so emotional and so different to anything that any magazine had ever covered before. We were really keen to get that.
The venue for the wedding has been chosen as this exclusive country house hotel on the outskirts of Hatfield Heath Village.
The hotel gates, as close as the press pack were allowed, the media tension, huge.
All of a sudden, there seemed to be this kind of bidding war to get Jade's television wedding. And I just called Max and I was like, hang on a minute, I am in this hospital and we are filming this wedding.
The rights to Sunday's wedding pictures have already been sold to OK Magazine as well as Living TV.
The deal that we signed with Max and Jade was astronomical.
Having sold the rights to her wedding for reportedly close to £1 million, any breach of security here could cost her dearly.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you please stand and welcome your bride party?
When Jade got married, it was her dream day. She was marrying the love of her life. But on top of that, it was this huge performance. She was trying to make a load of money for the boys. So she had a magazine there. She had us filming the show. She was on a lot of drugs. Looking back, it was amazing. She got down the aisle.
Turn your eyes upon Jesus, look full in his wonderful face. And may the blessing of the all-loving God rest upon you. Can I ask everyone to be upstanding then, please?
Halfway through the ceremony, it was most bizarre situation, because all of a sudden, one of our photographers came running down the corridor chasing this man. And she said, oh, it's a reporter from a newspaper. Stop him. He ran out into the garden, then dashed behind some bushes. About 5 seconds later, he came running back out again, followed by six really burly bodyguards. And it turned out he was a reporter from The Sun. And he had craftily slipped his camera disc down his underpants and then told us that we were disgraceful for making money out of Jade's wedding. And then we thought to ourselves, but you've just broken into the wedding, so I think you're doing exactly the same thing.
But most of all, the only thing I'd like to say is how beautiful my wife is tonight.
No, I would never have dreamed of anything like this, and I'm just so grateful for you, and I love you all so, so much, and I don't ever want to leave you. And I'm not gonna, because I'm gonna get through this, so I'm not gonna. But you've got such a special place in my heart. I'm gonna get tearful, but I'm gonna carry on.
She was in excruciating pain. She's going through the worst kind of pain, but she's not showing it to anyone, and everyone's just saying, you look beautiful, this is a beautiful day. She was dancing.
I have loved you for the last time.
She stays because it's her wedding day.
Is it a video? Is it a video? Touched you for the last time. Is it a video? Is it a video? For the love, for laughter, I flew up to arms. Is it a video? Is it a video?
I think I cried the whole day. I couldn't see anything but sadness for me, because I thought this is the end of their love story. This is usually the start of a couple's life, and to know that this is the end of their life, the sadness was overwhelming.
She'd been on the dance floor a lot. She'd been dancing with Jack, and then they went out and we watched fireworks, and her and Jack and the boys were sat on the bench. Sorry. And she gave me a look. It was just a look, which was... Stop now. I don't remember tapping the cameraman on the shoulder, saying that that's it. It's the final shot. And I remember walking away, being relieved for her that she'd just given up.
Did you have a good day?
She became a star on television. She could now die on television. The Jade Goody story is being played out before the cameras to the very end.
The kind of tragedy for Jade is she doesn't even see, I would suggest, that this is abnormal, that this is not normal behaviour.
If we carry on like this, are we going to have celebrity deaths? Is it going to be a fake TV event?
Over the shoulder.
The christening was hard because, you know, we were having photos taken of us, and like, who wants to smile? Even the boys, like making them pose. But for Jade, it was like, they're gonna get X amount for this. So that was like, right, playing along here. Doesn't feel right. We're playing along.
Max, can we have a quick word, please?
She was happy to be led by, I guess, her agent.
Can you tell us how it went in there?
He was given a very simple brief, which was to make the maximum. And I guess he did that.
You've said you'll tell Jade when you think enough is enough. Is it enough now?
As I've always said, it really is up to Jade, to decide. It's her life, it's her future. And the most important thing is that Jade does what Jade wants to do.
He was taking something that was really personal and just making it into a circus. He did well off it. Did he add to the quality of her life? No. But again, I had to just take my back seat.
When we all come out of the hospital, they were everywhere. Jesus Christ, that's bang out of order. My daughter's dying. You know what I mean?
The thing about this story is it's looking grimmer and grimmer and grimmer, and it's scaring the pants off me.
If her death leads to other people checking for cancer earlier, wouldn't that in a sense be a monument to her?
What was amazing about her is that she didn't say no to anything.
Hi, Jade, you okay?
Hi, Jade, how are you feeling? All right.
Thank you.
Eventually, the Royal Marsden, it almost turned into a red carpet at the front steps.
I'll never forget, I got a phone call from Danny to say, we've got these incredible pictures of Jade on a stretcher. I mean, I was on the sun for over 25 years, and I don't think I'd ever been in a situation like that before. I mean, I can remember being asked by an editor, are you sure we can publish these pictures? There was just general astonishment that was allowed to happen.
It was almost the show must go on, because the show was coming to an end. So let's get what we can for you until the end. And that's the harsh reality of the reality. I don't think either of us knew. I don't know if it was right or wrong now. To be perfectly honest, I don't. That was what we did. That's what she did. And we did it.
A lot of people have commented that Jade's very public battle will hopefully go some way to improve cervical cancer screening. Already the numbers of people getting tested have rocketed.
This is one of the most extraordinary narratives. At the point where Jade Goody first entered that ridiculous house 7 years ago, no one could have believed what would happen as a consequence.
No, that's absolutely true. She is a story of our time.
If she's watching, we wish you all the best, Jade.
It's my turn. And God, was it my turn. I washed her, I cleaned her, I creamed her. I done everything. Like, a mum should do. One night, she felt really scared, because obviously she knew she's going very soon. She said, Mum, I feel like they're coming to get me, they're coming to get me, it's going all dark. She went, is that because I was so bad in Big Brother?
Where's my big boy gone? Right, Fred, sit there. Right, ready?
The day before Mother's Day, which was the Saturday evening, Bobby and Freddie came in.
Oh, yeah. Did you say happy birthday, Nan? Yeah? You're tired, aren't you?
Now she's in semi-conscious now, like she's gone. And Freddie got in bed, in proper bed with her, laid beside her, and went, Mum, are you Mummy Jade or Mummy Angel? Nana, what is she? I said, she's still Mummy Jade. He said, okay. He said, now she's Mummy Jade. Can I go and stay with Nick Knack, which was one of his school friends? I said, of course you can. And Jeff took him to Nick Knack's, and then we got a phone call. Freddie's in bits, crying his eyeballs out. He said, I will promise you I won't cry no more, but I need you to let me know if she's Mummy or Mummy Angel. And she's Mummy Angel now. And he went, can you tell her good night for me? I said, good night. And he put the phone down.
Bye.
Wave,
Freddie.
Bye.
Love you.
Say love you, 2 and 1.
Bye. Hey, good boy. Bye. Oh.
Good morning, welcome to Breakfast from BBC News. It's Sunday, March the 22nd.
The former reality television star Jade Goody has lost her battle with cancer.
The mother of two young boys passed away on the same day the British celebrate Mother's Day.
The Mirror sums up her death with the headline, Mummy's in Heaven.
Earlier today, the Prime Minister, Gordon Brown, described her as courageous, both in life and death.
Three cheers for Jade! Hip, hip! Hip, hip!
On behalf of all the people in Bermondsey, I knew you'd be like this. I knew you'd come and say goodbye like this. So from everyone in Bermondsey, goodbye.
God, it was weird. The streets were lined with hundreds and hundreds of people. I mean, I've got like massive goosebumps talking about it. What an enormous impact she made on British society in her short life.
It was young girls and mums, it was kids, and everyone in Loughton shut their shops. They just lined the streets. Maybe it gave people hope that had been brought up without a secure family or in a council flat, had no money. Maybe sort of a girl done good, you know? If she did it, I can.
Church, that side, books of condolences this side.
We love you, Jade!
One of the aspects of the service, I'm told, is a DVD of Jade's life. It'll look back at Jade's life and her best bits.
Life will never be the same without you by my side. Grief almost too much to bear, pain difficult to hide.
I'm pleased that she's out of her pain.
She's doing it real.
And she's gone to a better place.
I think she's a great mother. And all what she stood for, being herself. Strong woman.
We're going to stand together now and join in singing a great gospel hymn reminding us of Jesus' death for us.
The whole idea of modern celebrities that it replaces religion, Jade, is a deep symbol of this. A short life, a quick death. You know, she's a sacrifice almost. And Jade Goody, oddly enough, was the first real sacrifice of reality television, and now there are many.
MPs have joined calls for the Jeremy Kyle show to be taken off air for good after the death of a man shortly after he appeared on the programme.
Love Island has been scarred by the deaths of two of its former stars.
Well, Jade was the first real hardcore symbol of a world to come.
Any comments, Mr. Coulson?
Her death was the end of an era that is represented by the phone hacking scandal, by the end of the news of the world.
And when Andy Coulson heard the word guilty, he didn't move an inch. He just looked straight ahead.
And I can tell you that Max Clifford has been sentenced to 8 years in prison, a total sentence of 8 years for those series of sex crimes.
The past is crumbling. The power is crumbling. Jade is just before social media really takes over, and there could be millions of Jades who really control their own narrative.
Hello, everyone.
Everyone can create their own reality TV show.
A victory for real people.
The world is going to be completely different. And Jade is a hint of that. You know, she was a sign of what was to come.
I'm a Bermondsey puss. Yeah, I know, I'm a Bermondsey girl. And all these years now, I'm still in Bermondsey. She, do you know what? She used to go mad. She just wanted to buy me an house out of London. And I just said no. She said, you're going to die in that flat. But there's so much good memories here, right? I can walk down the river, I chill, and I look up in the sky, and I don't know how silly it might sound to you lot out there, but I've seen Jade. People say Jade was a Bermondsey princess because she came from nothing. Does that make her story a fairy tale? I'm not sure, to be truthful with you. But then pull it all together. What a beautiful life she's had.
If you have been affected by the issues raised, support information is online at channel4.com/support.